Hello everybody, this is Josh Bycer from GameWisdom.com. Welcome back to another play of Path of Exile Hardcore. I am on my Shadow build this time. So I did a little bit of playing off recording, because I just wanted to make some more progress to try to get back to where I was with my duelist character. We made some decent progress here on the old skill tree. I'm thinking about getting this Vol pack and seeing what exactly it will do. Now that we got the Claw Mastery going, maybe I will refund this 10 and go over here. I also have a new trap, a lightning trap that I got down there, along with my bear and fire trap. So I'm really going in with the traps and hopefully with the Claw Lifesteal. We come over here. So still need to get over here, fight this one, and do all the quests on the west side. Other than that, we have two claws there. Let's see. Getting to the point where I can start making use of some of this stuff, I think. I have a new jewel, but I don't remember where I put it. Is this it? Yeah. Right there. Let's drop this stuff off. I think it's time to make some room. I did get to the point where I think she's selling gems.
Hello.
Now. Let's just sell this stuff first. Yes. Oh, and I also have a new... I have my first bit of a... chain ability, or a cast here, with the Herald of Ice. Can't use that. I wonder if I want Arctic Armor. We'll need to see how things go. Before we leave, I just want to alt-tab out for a split second just to make sure that this is still... is actually streaming. There we go. Once I get back to Act 3 and where my last character met his untimely end, I won't do a... streaming won't be as long. I'm just trying to rush back there at the moment. I've kind of made my bed with the Claw Mastery, so we'll need to see what that will do. Okay, so we got this. We'll have to go north anyway. Do this. But right now I am very beefy in terms of damage. With splash damage now on my double strike, we're basically killing most enemies in a few hits. And bosses, I can basically tank the damage they put out, at least for some of the lower level bosses. Oh, let's activate that. There's the new lightning trap. Oh, you're still alive. Okay, so there should be a waypoint around here. These guys shouldn't be too bad. Cannot believe that miss.
Just need a moment.
Ten. do want to test what that ball healing will do. I figure we might as well get it now, rather than, you know, get it right before a boss fight and realize it may not be worth it for us. Okay, so this is where Owl's crew is. And there's still so many ways for me to go in terms of these traps. I think I need more mana regen. I thought I saw an eerie light over here. Trying to pay attention to how much mana I'm actually getting back. It seems to work when there's multiple enemies, but it's not providing more mana than I'm putting out when it's a one-on-one fight. That wasn't too bad. The splash damage is just really doing wonders for this build. And this bear trap does a lot of damage. As you can see, it's almost one-hitting these guys. And while won't one-hit bosses or elites, it still does some decent damage that I don't need to be engaged with to do. So I think when I level up again in like the next probably 5 minutes. Oof. Treasure guy. Get back here, you. You can see. That's why I want to get those resistances going. Okay. See what we got. No. I think ours is still better, or at least more related to what we are using. Okay, so I think I'm going to refund. I'm going to take this off. And we will go 1, 2. So remember, these bigger skills are basically the build definers for your character. They'll change something dramatically about how your character will respond. I don't think I applied it. 1 second. Now we're also right here next to this. And this is Chaos Resistance. 4, 10, 16, and 22. Oh wait. 24. It's good when you can't do math at the heat of the moment there. It may be tempting to get at least up to these resistances. That'll be something more for the late game, though. Now, I could reduce my aura, which I believe is this. Flat damage. But let's go with this for right now. Oh, I just got an achievement. And then I can start making my way over there. So now the way that I absorb health has changed. And I'm kind of curious to see what it will actually do. My life leech should be more potent now. But I believe it comes at a cost. Okay, this is the way forward. That will take us to the end of the act. Alright, so. I actually want to see them hit me. Wait for it. Okay, so that's working. That's my repose proccing. Okay, so the repose is kind of ruined my test there. Slot wise, we almost got everything full. I have room for one more blue. At least I was able to see partially that I was recovering health through my potion. Okay, here's oak.
I need more pockets.
We fill up so fast, don't we? I doubt this will be better. No. But right here, with these guys who do chaos damage, getting those resistances will help me there. And I think that boss who killed me with my last character was using chaos-based attacks.
Creighton sent you.
Yeah, I'd rather... I think I'm just gonna kill you, buddy. That's it, all you swarm around me.
To a knife fight.
Seemed like we recovered health pretty quickly. And more importantly, I was recovering health through the potion, so it seems to be working well for us. So that's one down, one to go. So, we can take a second here. I do want to get over here. That is kind of interesting. If I'm going to go all in with claws, I definitely want to get this. This whole rack here. And then, of course, if I want to do more with traps, we have this right there. Life leech supply to energy shield. And we have more chaos based damage. This is super risky. This is if you want to go all in with energy shields. These guys are several levels below me, so there's a reason why they're cracking so easily.
Just need a moment to catch my breath.
Now I can only have three traps out normally. But if I can enhance that, if I can get the right passive, I can make more. Or have four. Die, evil monkeys. I think there was a monkey, actually. Alright, let's see what we got. One second, grab my drink. That isn't bad, but it's really came a little too late, I think, for us to use that. Lightning trap should be getting leveled up.
I need more pockets.
Oh, I think I know what they mean. Life regeneration has no effect. I have certain items on that I think give me partial life regen. Where is it? Not life steal. No. There are items in the game. Here it is. That 1.1 life regenerated per second, that no longer applies to me because of the Vol Pack lifesteal. Oh, look at you. I just killed this clone, apparently. There we go. As you can see, my life is not regenerating by itself anymore. But my ability to steal life, either through leeching with the claws or passives, has grown. And that's the whole point of these bigger skills. They're meant to give you something at the expense of something else. If you get the right ones for your build, it'll help out a whole lot. If you screw around with it, it can really leave you in a weaker place. Of course, we got the suicide guys now. Oh, that's good.
I need more pockets.
I really want to try this. Here it is. And we found a waypoint. We'll head back to town in 1 second. I'm trying to see just how much damage this is actually doing. Ow. Not horrible. Maybe I'll keep it on just to level. And the DOT bonus that I can get for the traps should apply to that as well. Okay.
Let me tell your future. A horror from the past returns to cause pain in a place that had never called home.
Okay. You don't need it. Don't need it. I think we'll keep that. I think I'll hold on to that too.
Return if you must.
Oh, a question, Hembon. Yeah, this is free to play. Path of Exile is entirely free to play. You can either play it from, you can either download the client from their own site, or you can also just get attached to your Steam account. If you want to spend money on the game, you simply go to the microtransaction shop, and they have a whole lot of stuff you can buy, but none of it is game affecting in the sense that you're buying more abilities or special powers and stuff like that. Now then there should be... Okay, I just want to see this. Now, this thing is doing chaos damage, which means that it's not easily resisted. That's what makes it so special, too. 3.2 becomes 5.7. So that should be growing more and more in power. Saying the wrong one. There we go. But my lightning trap is getting pretty awesome, too. Okay, so we are looking for... Is this where we need to go? Yeah. Okay. Spindle's there. Where is... She's here, too. Wonder if there's an achievement for clearing this place out. Back here. Ooh. There you try and flicker strike me. Aw. Nothing good out of that. So it doesn't seem like we got a huge we got a huge whammy from taking the Vol pack. At least not for this build. This means it's gonna be a lot easier to life leech. But again, you do need to be really careful with which one of those bigger perks you take. So this is, deals 3.9 now, it went from 5.2 to 7.5, 6 to 15, I think these are still the higher quality. Right now the only reason I have any kind of strength going on is I need it for the melee splash damage that we have. Oh, I see something bad. That's it. Everyone stand the fire. This build that I'm doing right now is probably, in the long run, will be more powerful than my other one, but it's still very risky as it's built around getting a lot of key skills and passives. Because I'm going all in with claws, it means that by choice, I have to ignore all other weapon types. Ooh, what's this? Oh. If we were an archer or use bows, that would be perfect. Oh, and I was told on YouTube, you can move the full map around using the arrow keys. So thank you for bringing that up. I think I could probably fit another aura of some kind on this character. Maybe we'll do a look once we finish this set of quests, because they do add new stuff the further you get in the act. Let's see, how is that doing? Contagion is still really not at the point that it's doing a lot of damage. But again, this was a beginning game skill that I'm just now leveling up. I could have bought it too, I just didn't think about it at the time. I do like the fact that it does spread to multiple enemies. Should be coming to the end of this place. what's going on here. 24, this is now... I think it just went up in length. Or duration, I'm sorry. Very good. There's the actual boss fight. Anyone over here? I shouldn't say boss, just elite. This is where contagion and my bear trap will come in handy. Heading back, I might as well.
I need more pockets.
So we don't need.
Welcome. The Plague War's followers feed on the flesh of the dead, a desecration of the mother's work.
Okay. 88. I wonder if it's time to maybe buy and upgrade some better armor. Because we are based on evasion and energy shield, those are two things that we do want to keep on top of. Anything else? Ten life gain. This is better in terms of sockets. I think maybe I will buy that and see about leveling up, especially since I have another orb of alchemy. Plus it will do better than this in terms of sockets too.
Going?
Killed Mother Adelaide.
Alright, what do we have? Faster casting, faster... That would be really great, except I think we are already attacking really fast. If we get green, red, green, that could be useful. Or wait, maybe if I apply it to this... Trap and mine support. It's a green blue. That's the first time I think I've seen something like that. That is tempting. 31% more elemental damage. Since I haven't seen this before, I didn't want to take this. Wait a minute. So that is it green? Apparently it is green. Well, I'm going to eventually get more sockets, so... I'll take it because I haven't seen it before.
The tree that Gina calls Larat.
Yeah. Oh, Gina.
Hello.
There you go. Physical lightning. Power charge. Kill enemies have 10% life or lower when hit by support skills. That's interesting. Point blank shot, hold of fire, increase critical damage. Here's that melee. You know, I think I'm gonna buy this. Trap in mind, concentrate effort, faster attacks. Cannot cause bleeding. 100% reduced critical strike chance. This, I don't know if I want this or not. It basically gives me life, additional life leech at the cost I'm losing health per second. This just seems very risky when we're playing on hardcore. Herald of Ash, Herald of Ice, that's what I have. Tempest Shield, Arctic Armor, Desecrate. Okay. So if I place this here, can't do that. I honestly don't know this is affecting it. Oh wait, did I grab the wrong one?
You help us, and we help.
I think I did. Cold of fire, cooling strike. There it is, melee. Oh, so no, I can't use that. Alright. And of course, to make sure I get the most bang for my buck, I'm going to use my armorer. If I can actually see it in my giant list of gems. On it. That's weapon. Here it is. And you want to do this before you upgrade because you only need 4 as opposed to maybe 10 or 12. You can see the value. 106 to 32 is already better than this epic gear. So now I'll use my Orb of Alchemy. Reflects 22 physical damage to melee attackers. Put that on. And because I'm a hoarder, I think I'll hold on to that. Is there anything badass that I've been holding on to that I can use now? Where is that? Need to put this next to one of my traps, which would have to be here. This is the other part of the game when you start mixing and matching gems. I'm gonna put it in here, but I doubt by then I'm gonna get lost with it. Let's get rid of that. That's good socket wise. Do I have any diamond rings I can wear now? This 1 to 2. Anything else? So much stuff, don't I? Alright, let's see. We're just not lightning damage spec.
What do you want?
Alright, in you go. I think that's enough playing around here. Let's get back to killing.
Going?
Still need to level up one more time to get that good stuff. Okay. You will defeat a very powerful monster. Oh, because we spend more than 15 minutes. So there's apparently something really bad here now. We have to open up the path back to the first area. Okay. We already run in there, obviously. Dallas is going to be strong enough to kill these guys by itself. Take that. We're going to have to fight a mini boss too. So far, so good. Here we go. We have to go back to the starting area to unlock that quest. But before we do that, we need to deal with whoever this powerful boss is, hopefully, I should say, and the final bandit to get our big 10% resist.
Another corrupted I have a certain pack to help you out.
Right, so she's saying there's something here that I can kill. Goal for tonight's stream is to hopefully get through to Act 3, maybe even beyond that. Ooh. that's scary.
Low on mana.
If I'm going to go all in with dodge, it may be worth it to get these bonuses down there. Because at the moment, I don't think I'm dodging spells. Yeah, I'm not seeing it. And even if we get less of an energy shield, it may still be worth it. Here's an app by one additional invasion boss.
You're a creature by creature, we'll put this land.
Where are you, powerful creature? I believe her little hut should be around here. There it is. There you are.
Some scared little bit.
You can see she's blowing the corpses up.
Did the earth move for you, baby? Probably. You hit the ground quite hard.
I just love this guy. He's basically a serial killer. That's all he does is go around and kill people, and he loves it. Good for us. Okay. What the? Now we just need to find this strange boss. I have a feeling we'll know it when we see it. Again, the contagion's not doing a whole lot of damage, but it's doing reliable damage. I only need to check an enemy's resistances in order for that to hurt me. Is that it? No, I think the boss will usually glow. Can't blind me. That bear trap just... Oh, that was it.
A horror from the past returns to cause pain in a place that it never called home.
Okay. More boot helmet. Okay, so we got the spike that lets us go forward. We can go back to the first area. Let's bump all that up. And I think I'm going to head over here. I'm going to go for, I think, that spell dodge bonus. It's risky, but If it's one of the only ways that will allow me to actually dodge incoming spells, it could be worth it for us. Especially since I don't have armor. So when a spell hits me, I'm taking the full impact of it. Full minus the energy shield, of course.
Well,
yeah.
The earth shifts beneath the feet of many, but they are not the prey this monster seeks.
I will take that. Alright, do you have anything new for me? This could be a minute. We use that, that ain't dead. Orb storm, real knives. We are using dual strike for sure. And that's it. Okay, so here we have another one of those big moments. I can either go down here and start augmenting my traps. This doesn't help us since we're not using poison. But going down here, can't use that. Again, you can just see some of the crazy effects that are possible. Deal no non-fire damage, minions explode. Spend energy shield before mana. Energy shield protects mana instead of life. Life leech is applied. Okay. So I think we're going to go down here. And again, you can see here, so it'll increase my chance of dodging by 30%, let's see. 30% less chance. Oh, to block spells, not to dodge. So again, because I'm going a dodge build, I think I want to get this track. Okay, so now we need to come back up here, drop this off at the guy, he's gonna give me my big 10 resist to everything, except for chaos, of course. And now we're gonna head into the latter half of Act 2. I believe he's down here. Now, what, you will encounter powerful devourers. Oh, there he is. And most likely, I am going to want, again, to get over here for more life leech. And that's the thing about the meta of Path of Exile. Once you commit to one of these builds, you really need to follow through, because you're not going to be able to vary your build in such a way. Pick this up to sell. You can see he's hitting me with those spell blast. But if I can get that bonus, it will give me a chance to actively dodge that. Or not actively, but it'll be one of my chances. Let's hold that up. There must be more devourers around. Where is this guy? I think this is him. Is it? Okay, so now it's above. And you can see the damage really starting to at least make some noticeable difference against them. Bear trap. There he is.
I need more pockets.
Getting some lag for some reason.
My garden's all tidy. Sweet.
Okay, he gives us this. And now we have a big 10 resist to fire, cold, and lightning. One second. So this is interesting. If I take acrobatics, it's going to basically make repose, I think, possibly useless, because I'm going to lose 30% of my ability to block. Is there a way to compensate? Plus two. It's gonna be a tough choice. I mean, the ability to dodge spells, though, may be worth it. Here we go. And then pretty much I take out repose, so I won't be able to use it. We'll have to see what happens when the time comes. I think it may be a small price to pay, but it can help me deal with enemies like this a lot easier. I may need to do it. Fire probably isn't the best thing to use there. And that's the other thing about chaos damage. It's not blocked or resisted by shield, so it just eats directly into the enemy's health. Hmm. So get as strong as nothing and kill a lot of enemies. As you can see, they're doing the same thing to me. Those hits were going directly through my shield at my health. See, my health is no longer regenerating by normal, and it still is due to the Vile Pack. I feel I'm going the wrong way though. Here, I have a bear trap. Thanks to that splash damage, we're really good in groups now. Hopefully it's to the west. This is where we basically turn out the sun. So what's interesting is because I have an engine here. Oh, let me deal with these guys first. I could actually make use of this if I wanted to. Because I think it should get the bonus. I am level 24. Looking for the way up, I believe. There it is. Almost missed it too. Some areas seem to be randomly or procedurally generated and others aren't.
This shadow is starting to feel a little inadequate.
Okay. So this should take us out? Yeah. Now we basically blotted out the sun. They're doing some crazy chaos damage too. Should be a waypoint here. And this is just another little side area. My money is that there's going to be an achievement for clearing this place out, because it is such a limited area. But we'll see if I'm right or not. Hi everybody, Josh Bycer here. Hope you enjoyed the video, but this part is now over. This was cut from a larger video over on the Twitch stream, GW Bycer. As always, if you enjoyed these videos, be sure to share them with your friends and of course like and subscribe to the channel. Check out game-wisdom.com where I examine the art and science of games. Subscribe on Twitch and Twitter under GW Bycer to get the latest updates when content goes live, as well as random thoughts from me throughout the day. And you can find me on Patreon under Game Wisdom. Any donations will be greatly appreciated. It will allow me to keep putting out great content and bring back a fan favorite feature to the site. Anyway, while this part is over, be sure to check out the next part coming real soon to the Game Wisdom YouTube channel. Thanks again for watching.